This guy is one of the most hated people on the internet. Like, I think your average person hates him more than Kanye's biggest hater hates Kanye. And on the surface, this guy is just a game developer. Personally, I respect game developers a lot. Devs often have to suffer long hours away from their families, harsh deadlines, and oftentimes fans threatening their lives. And they just do that just for the sakes of our entertainment. But people just can't stand this one fella. Good evening, I'm Bagubuns, and you probably guessed who I'm talking about, because he has been the internet's punching bag for the better part of the last couple of years. This is Alex Mahan, also known as Yandere Dev, but I'll refer to him as Alex wherever possible, for reasons I'll get into later. I don't know how many people still remember when Yandere Simulator was blowing up on YouTube, but it was everywhere back in 2014. It's basically Hitman, but it's an anime love story based on both the Mirai Nikki and School Days series. My man, you have garbage anime taste. You fall in love with the most boring character in the game, but uh-oh, you got competition, and you dumped all your stat points into gaslighting instead of charisma. So, your only logical option is homicide and trying to get away with it. Why do you even like this guy so much? Can't you just talk to him or something? Well, at this rate, he'll never date you. To be completely honest, it's a pretty interesting video game concept, and there's a decent amount of fun to be had. It leaves a lot to be desired, but at least going through it with the missions was thrilling. And even messing around was kind of fun. While this isn't exactly my type of game, the project admittedly has potential to go somewhere. There's a reason why it took over YouTube Let's Plays at one point. The problem is, it just doesn't seem like it's gonna go anywhere anytime soon. I don't want this video to just summarize the controversies of the world's most hated game developer, since I think everybody already has. We all know that Alex's journey throughout this game's development is a train wreck, but instead of blindly writing a hit piece on him like everybody else, I want to dive into the deeper reason why people don't really like him, even before the controversies. And it all really boils down to Alex's human interactions, and how his perspective on other people has become problematic for his game and his reputation. Yandere Simulator is most likely Alex's fantasy. And no, I'm not expecting this to be an accurate portrayal of school life with real characters. Obviously, the visual style and one-dimensional tropey characters make it crystal clear that Yandere Simulator is based on Alex's love for the anime high school culture. It's important to mention that Alex grew up homeschooled, and my intention isn't to stigmatize that at all. But that also means that his perception of high school most likely comes entirely from mediums like anime, and the high school experience in many anime is oftentimes both rose-tinted and sexualized, which isn't a good look for Yandere Simulator. Need I explain why? At the time that Yandere Simulator started development, the age of consent in Japan was 13. Recently, it had been raised to 16, but Alex is an American video game developer whose target audience happens to include markets where the age of consent is 18. Let's do some math here. 16 is less than 18? This game has already been banned on Twitch before, because Alex is just the type of guy who has trouble complying to reasonable social standards. But for some reason, there are a lot of people who don't really agree that having these 18 plus themes in a high school setting is inherently problematic in this specific context. People try to rationalize it away by saying that it's based on anime that does the same thing. And everybody knows how socially acceptable anime shenanigans are. Or that the game portrays it as being messed up because our main girl's a bit messed up. And I totally understand that the point of these suggested themes probably wasn't to glorify them. In fact, maybe it's the exact opposite. But your intentions ultimately don't matter if you can't make them clear. And with the way Yandere Simulator deals with these topics, I think it's fair to say that Alex probably should have steered far clear of that stuff. There's no good reason why our high school protagonist's bonuses are affected by her panties. Could have been a book bag or something, I don't know. These aren't just features that Alex overlooked. These are integrated into the fabric of the game. Speaking of fabric, another very divisive aspect of this game is framing your classmates by shoving camera up their skirts. Sometimes the players themselves are even given a full view of the nether regions. Let me remind you, these students can be from the ages of 15 to 18. People that defend the upskirting argue that since it's been established that this is a bad thing, if the protagonist does this bad thing, that just makes the protagonist a bad person. No, duh. But that point could be proven in the other messed up stuff that she does. So I think it's in poor taste to deliberately have a separate option where the players themselves are at risk of engaging in borderline child pornography. It doesn't matter if it was written as a commentary on harassment or something. You're giving the player the option of getting all up in the no-no zones of underage girls when there are other ways around it. It also probably didn't help with the grooming allegations. I won't jump to the conclusion that this is a fetish sort of thing, because I don't think I want to know, but I will say that whatever is in the game is way too much. And it's a bit dehumanizing, no? You know the Discord mod stereotype? All I'm saying is that Alex runs a tight ship around here. Sometimes a little too tight. I'm not allowed to say Pookie? Alex, I'm being suffocated here. Alex doesn't know how to communicate with his fans or his haters. It's not just that I think his popularity wasn't exactly handled well, I also think that there aren't a ton of people who take him seriously anymore. He has a reputation of responding poorly to criticism and being toxic to people who don't speak in the exact tone that he likes. And I could sympathize with that because he's clearly been burnt before. There are a ton of fake screenshots of Alex saying some creepy stuff, and it's really hard to know which ones are completely real and which ones are fake. Do people really believe that he's that much of an incel? However, it's clear that he doesn't respond to the trolls very well and lets his emotions overwhelm him from time to time. Because his fanbase knows that this kind of stuff gets to him, they keep poking the bear, and no matter how much he expresses that he doesn't like it, there isn't really anything he could do to stop it. And I don't think the internet is in the right to keep lampooning him, even if he isn't that great of a guy. So to anybody watching this, no prank calls, death threats, anything of the sort, just make memes. Everything that Alex manages or has managed is censored so heavily. He isn't even on Discord anymore, and you can just feel his presence lurking around the server. Type every message as if Yandere Dev himself was standing over your shoulder watching you type it, because he is! I know I'm locking my doors and windows extra tight tonight. They had to form an entire other subreddit to counter r/yandere_simulator called r/osana. It's not even necessarily made for ripping the guy apart, although they do that a lot. It's a place where people in the Yandere Simulator community can voice their thoughts without Alex peeking over your shoulder all the time. There's a reason why people speedrun getting banned from the Discord server. If you receive this much backlash from both haters and fans of the project, you can't hide behind a forum or a written apology anymore. You kind of have to accept your screw-ups and learn from it. What's more messed up is that because of all these restrictive rules, Alex shuts out some of his diehard fans. I understand that he wants to prevent both trolls and inappropriate conversations. Ironic, I know. But there are still so many strange decisions made. For one, he isolates his international audience, especially the ones that don't know English, and for no good reason. I actually think his foreign audience would be more supportive of Alex than his English-speaking audience, because they wouldn't be able to follow the mountains upon mountains of his wrongdoings. I could already see the clickbait YouTube titles. Yandere Dev exposed as being racist? I don't think he's racist, I just think the moderation team is really lazy. On his official Discord and Reddit, any language other than English is just assumed to be trolling because they won't know what you're saying. My guy, let me introduce you to Google Translate. It's older than most of your fanbase. Speaking of which, he wants only mature and refined adults in his community. So there are a lot of jokes you can't make, and a lot of phrases you are not allowed to say. You're not allowed to be cutesy, use common emojis, or even roleplay? Do you even know your audience? Tell me that somebody with a dedicated gacha club server isn't also into roleplay. Let's look at one of the approved suggestions in the Discord server. Yandere Simulator needs a poo and pee meter that gradually increases during the day. If they are full, Ayano pees or poops in her pants. Ugh. What a mature suggestion. I don't think it's that deep, but you kind of have to accept that a lot of your audience isn't made up of mature English-speaking adults. His entire community is just an echo chamber of people that agree with him. Yandere Simulator is known as the game that will never be finished, and it was like that before all of Alex's talent wanted nothing to do with him anymore. While I could take a delay better than the average person, many people are accusing him of dragging it out on purpose to keep reaping that backer money. I mean, game development is tough, but if you're able to fully flesh out a side game before you even completed a quarter of your main game, your priorities are in the wrong place. And no, I'm not acknowledging the fan games made out of spite that took only a few weeks to develop. None of them were that much better anyways, and a lot was based on assets that already existed. It's painfully obvious that Alex does not have organizational skills or a directorial vision, and this is a problem even if he was developing Yandere Simulator solo. But he isn't. Other people's time, effort, and careers are on this thing as well. Voice actors, modelers, composers, volunteers are all in the hands of a guy that's bouncing around projects like he's cheating on his hypothetical wife. For example, every single year, he decides to develop a minigame for Halloween. I could commend him for trying to do something cool to please his fans, but that time isn't being allocated to the actual game. And hey, I get it. You get burnt out of working on the same things for so long, so you just need to stretch those creative muscles and do something else. But Alex also developed an entire other game mode inside a Yandere Simulator that is pretty much the same as the base game, but with different aesthetics. 1980s mode is basically fully finished. Why can't that just be Yandere Simulator? Even despite how often he chases down other projects, the way he manages the people working for him is not very good. First of all, you have to be 18 to volunteer for the game. Vagabonds, what's wrong with that? That seems perfectly reasonable. Yeah, it is perfectly reasonable. The issue stems from the fact that Alex doesn't care. Plenty of his workers came out saying that they were underage when they started to work for him. How bad can it possibly be if you turn one of your biggest fans into one of your biggest haters? This artist, whose channel I'll link below, has come out about the hard work she has put into art that was going to be in the final game, just for it to be nothing but a placeholder for Alex's lead artist to trace over. It was still her design, and it was made at Alex's request in the exact way he wanted it. And then he stole it and erased her name from it. And I don't know why. It looks so good. On Tumblr, Alex tried to refute the claims that were made about the volunteers being disposable, saying that he was disposable and that you could leave him whenever you want. This is not an example of that, Alex. This is plagiarism. The introverted cartoonist made the artwork, and by United States copyright law, she has the right to decide where it's shown and who is allowed to make fan art of it. And as somebody who likes to take the side of the artist, Alex, you're a scumbag and a thief that brings down the hopes and dreams of people with talent. I think because they're volunteers that don't have a contract, Alex thinks he could just use them however he likes and repurposes only their best ideas. If that sounds redundant, it's because it is. This is not the only case of this. I'll link this Twitter feed with people coming out about their horrible work experience, not only with Alex, but his volunteers as well. Alex doesn't seem to like the volunteer culture very much. He always complains about them, but the reason he's still humors them is because he likes the benefits of them being volunteers. He believes that's free labor for him. He could get around child labor laws, and he doesn't have to use ideas that he doesn't like, but he really doesn't care for them, and is really bad at managing and directing them. Dude, teamwork makes the dream work. Am I right, fellas, or am I right, fellas? If you're committed to having volunteers, then you should respect their time and ideas. If you don't, that's a waste of time and energy, not only for them, but for you and your project. Without Yandere Simulator social media and people pledging money every month on Patreon, Alex does not have a job. So it's only reasonable for people who are backing this project to receive truthful feedback as to what is taking so long or what the money is going to. Unfortunately, Alex is the kind of guy that has no problem looking his audience in the eye and lying to them. Every controversy is met with a cover-up or an excuse, and it's pretty exhausting to talk about. But I think the worst thing he does is lie about where he dedicates his time, effort, and money. Remember that one time where he said he doesn't have time to develop Yandere Simulator because he's too busy reading emails?
Sometimes I spend between 8 and 12 hours going through my email, leaving me with no time left in the day to write code for the game.
8 to 12 hours of emails? What, are you doing tech support or something? I don't buy it. People have been speculating that Alex is just playing games or something instead, but it doesn't really matter where he's spending it as long as he's honest about what he's doing. And I'm willing to bet it's not just staring at emails for that long. And let's talk about Alex's adult doll scandal. Yeah, let's put it that way. In the debunk section of the forum, Alex states that people try to sign him up for strange accounts under his email, which I don't doubt, but there is this one site that he is engaged with that he spent quite a lot of money on. It's hard to tell how much of the income was from Yandere Simulator fans, since this was around the time he stopped taking freelance jobs to work on the game full time. And we know from screenshots of the forum that Alex started accepting donations for the game in December of 2014. And we also know he bought the doll in 2015. In the forums, Alex, under a different name, posted a number of suspicious things that linked him to the doll, like his doll being represented as a freshman in the game, or his obsession with Zero Suit Samus. The evidence that seals the deal, though, was somebody that linked the username with Alex's email and found out that it was a match. After Alex found out, he tried to deny it ever since. I've come to the conclusion that Alex clearly has problems opening up to people, hiding behind this character that is Yandere Dev, and I can understand why. This stuff is pretty embarrassing to admit, but other people donated to see Yandere Simulator, not for you to seek personal pleasure. Everybody knows it, so the best thing you could do is to come clean about it. And I don't think people are mad that Yandere Simulator isn't complete as much as they are that they don't know why it's not complete. Oh boy, this topic. Before I start, I want you to know that I'm trying to be fair here. There is so much fake news out there about the situation that since Alex has a negative history with saying and doing suggestive things, people are just more likely to believe in anything that goes against him. But while I think the internet blows a lot of things way out of proportion, his documented and proven interaction with minors is still unacceptable. He tries his best to put restrictions on his community to prevent talking to minors, but he hasn't really stuck to his guns on that one. I hate to beat a dead horse even deader, but you might have remembered clips of Alex saying some predatory stuff. Now, the story floating around on the internet was perpetuated by a content creator called AliMCC, and all of this was allegedly leaked against the wishes of the victim in question. I mean, I would too. If you're a YouTuber, how can you possibly resist this juicy piece of info that was handed to you by the victim? I've read Alex's apology, and I've read the victim's statement as well, and props to Alex for having the guts to own up to how predatory it actually came out, and even leaving a donation to a credible organization that treats abuse survivors. However, you still have to acknowledge that Alex is in his mid-30s and is claiming to crack sexually charged jokes online to somebody he knows is 16. Like, at this point, can we just expect a Chris Hansen moment when this stuff starts to go on? Just because the victim is supposedly fine with it doesn't mean it's acceptable in the first place. Alex should be old enough to know that doing something like this isn't just a little oopsie. And if he really didn't realize how predatory he sounded at first, well, that's an even bigger issue. To be completely fair, I think the victim behind this whole ordeal isn't in the right for playing along with his behavior either, and I find her suspicious and inconsistent. What do you mean that you didn't want AliMCC to upload it? Maybe think about that before sending over the evidence? But the fact of the matter is, doesn't matter what your intentions are, maybe don't do the naughty talk with underage girls. Listen, I will never defend the horrible stuff that he did do, but I also think he's very misguided. The allegations and nasty stuff often stems from a troubled past or struggles with mental health as a public figure on the internet, and he doesn't exactly have many people in his life to turn to. He doesn't even trust his parents, which is just sad, man. His background might mean that he isn't very accustomed to social norms, and I'd imagine the sudden shift in his popularity brought about a lot of unwanted attention. I truly believe he is passionate about Yandere Simulator, even though he probably gets burnt out quite a bit. And getting hate over a majority of its decade-long development cycle is rough. But even though he's clearly been troubled for a long time, people seem to be complacent and just hating him, since talking about him on the internet every now and again brings in that sweet, sweet YouTube money. I think the best course of action for this guy is to get him some therapy and get him more situated with society. God gives second chances, so why shouldn't we? Alex says he doesn't want therapy because then he can't work on Yandere Simulator. But everybody on Earth knows he needs it. The signs are written all over his website. He clearly lives an isolating life, and he always uses his mental health issues as an excuse for the horrible things that he does, as if it weren't something he could at least deal with in some way. You can't convince me he doesn't have the time or resources to do so every once in a while. He's not a lawyer, for crying out loud. The reason why I called Yandere Dev Alex throughout this entire video is because I just want to treat him like a real human being, not like a monster or manipulator. I truly believe Alex's identity as Yandere Dev is holding him back. When we see him at his most vulnerable, we know that he clearly wants love and respect, but he's desperate, which is where a lot of his unsavory interactions come from. This isn't me falling for his victim blaming, it's me looking past that and recognizing that he is broken. He's gotten involved in so much nasty stuff during the time he's been working on Yandere Simulator, and a break from the lifestyle he's living would be for the best for his mental health issues and his productivity. If we are complacent in leaving him in this cycle of hate without changing changing the status quo, then more people will fall victim to Alex's repulsive instincts. I won't pretend to know anything about Alex's personal life, and I don't think I'm fixing him or anything like that. But I could tell, he needs to learn what it feels like to have meaningful interactions with people beyond his computer screen. He is not at all capable of holding his own against the internet as it is right now, and the backlash is clearly getting to him, which isn't productive or sustainable for anything that he wants to do. I'd like to eventually stop seeing his name plastered all over my YouTube feed for the wrong reasons, and I think that Yandere Simulator can be a pretty interesting project if the developer behind it can take the time to figure himself out first. The moral of this story? Touch some grass, dude! Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody. Yeah.